All right, let's go back to Florida and speak to Ted. Ted, welcome to the show, sir. What say you?
Oh, Josh, I got you.
You got me.
Oh, okay. We were talking last night about Governor Scott and Sheriff Finch and all that stuff going on in Liberty County.
All right.
On the email thing back and forth. And, you know, you asked me to call in, so here I am.
Okay, so for those who weren't listening to Wednesday's show, we had Adrian Wiley on talking about how Rick Scott is not really the conservative, the Republican, the Tea Party guy that Florida needs or wants. And there are other people who say, no, he's exactly what we need. He's exactly what we wanted. And that's the position you're taking, correct, Ted?
Yes, and a position also that Adrian Wiley would get absolutely nowhere, and some of the information he was feeding you yesterday is just total hooey.
Well, and here's the thing. Tell us why, because I don't want to make this about Adrian. It's not about Adrian. It's about whether Rick Scott's the right guy or not. Tell us why Rick Scott's the right guy.
Okay. Let's see. I don't have all this stuff in front of me, but one of the things he campaigned on was, you know, a reduction in some taxes, increases in employment. He had something he called a 700,000 jobs in 7 years or something like that. He wanted to get rid of the state airplanes that were a waste of time. He wanted to get rid of the high-speed rail. I don't remember if that was part of his campaign or not, but it's one of the things that he did pretty much right off the bat. It was mostly about the economics of the state. He's also a 10th Amendment guy. He's also a gun rights guy. He's basically...
Well, he's really not a gun rights guy or a 10th Amendment guy, but I will give you props that he is...
Now, before you make that statement, you better go take a look at how the Florida Constitution, the Oath of Office, and the Florida statutes are written. There's only so much that he can do, because built right in to our Florida Constitution are sections that say that, you know, we're going to support what the Supreme Court has to say about, say, Fourth Amendment. All right, it's right in there. You know, we have the right. I mean, they took the Fourth Amendment and basically stuck it in the Constitution, the state Constitution, and then added a caveat that, you know, Florida, in its Constitution, agrees to follow whatever the Supreme Court decides about that Fourth Amendment. And if Supreme Court...
Yeah, but that's not a valid excuse, Ted. You know better than that.
Wait. I didn't say it was a valid excuse. I said it's written into the state constitution. So an officer of the state, an elected official of the state, who is sworn to uphold the Constitution and the government, okay, that's part of his oath of office. He is sworn to uphold the Constitution and the government of the United States and of the state of Florida. So when he gets in there and he sees something that he believes is wrong, all righty, he's either going to have to get the legislature to, you know, change the law, change the Constitution, change the oath, do something so that he can legally actually do it. Now, in the case of
yeah, but he's not doing that, buddy.
Okay, the legislature's going to...
I mean,
have
but that's
to
that's my point,
it.
Ted. I mean, see, here's the general premise here. He's not doing that. If he would have came into office and said, hey, you know what? We have a messed up, jacked up system in Florida. It is immoral to follow the Florida Constitution. There is no way as a human being with any decency in my soul that I could allow this to continue. So I'm going to work with the legislature in order to change this. And it's not valid anyway, regardless of what the Florida Constitution says. It is illegal for me to follow my oath if it is a violation of the United States Constitution, because that is the that's the precedent in which I must follow, regardless of what my Florida Constitution and my Florida oath states. So I need to, as a human, as a man, and as a governor of Florida, subject myself to humanity, to subject myself to the Constitution of the United States first, because that's the first oath, and adhere to this principle of I will not violate the rights of the Constitution, regardless of what the Florida state says. Now, you know that's the truth.
Well,
and because he...
It's also very ideal. But let's get into a practical world here. Okay, that is ideal, and it is quite purist. And that's marvelous. But when it comes down to the practical application of that, you're going to have to deal with a whole lot of folks who don't see it that way, who don't understand it that way, and there's, Jesus, I mean, you can't possibly, all right, get up there into a public office. In the first place, trying to run on some kind of a platform like that would get you absolutely
Well, you don't
nowhere.
Have to run on
and
that platform. You don't have to run on that
get
platform.
Adrian Wiley absolutely nowhere, all right?
You don't have to run on that platform.
Let's take this. Let's just take this thing with Sheriff Finch. Here's the scenario.
No. Let's take Rick Scott. Let's take Rick Scott instead. Now, Rick Scott is against the privatization of prisons, right? Because he doesn't have a constitutional obligation to support that. So obviously, he's against it, right?
What do you mean he's against the privatization of prisons? As far as I know, he's been pushing for it.
Exactly. That's my point. So there's no constitutional oath of office requirement that says he has to do something as stupid as back the privatization of prisons. Yet he does it anyway.
Okay,
he's obviously not a guy.
Wait. You just said something as stupid as backing the privatization of prisons. Now, that
yes.
would be your opinion about what privatization of prisons is based on, I don't know what, but probably something that you have seen that happened the way when somebody... pulled, you know, did some kind of a process for privatizing
not at all
prisons. So why do you call it stupid then?
It is stupid because any time you place a corporation in charge of the execution of law enforcement judgments, you then place the business as an opposition to the people. It's just a mathematical, logical equation. There's no way to spin it or look at it in any other way other than to say it is now profitable to keep those prisons full. In a time when the state is in a contract, which is exactly what was outlined for Florida, where Florida would agree to keep those prisons at a certain level of capacity, it is then the state's obligation and duty to make sure you're a criminal so they can keep those prisons full. Otherwise, they default on their contract, which, again, that's not good, and they end up paying a fine, which, again, subjects the people to paying the fine. So there's no upside. There's no, you know, free market Republican premise to privatizing prisons. It's a diabolical way to actually enhance the totalitarian system, and he's not obligated to do that. He didn't take an oath to do that. And if he was a small business, pro-Constitution, pro-Republican Party, pro-Florida Constitution, pro-Florida oath, he would obviously oppose things like that, and he's not. So this has nothing to do with Sheriff Finch.
Well, your discussion yesterday was all about Sheriff Finch.
No, my discussion with Adrian Wiley spent the first 4 minutes about Sheriff Finch, and then we moved on to other topics.
Okay. One way or the other, what I've been seeing, and we're going to get back to the Sheriff Finch thing, and we're going to get on this HB 49 thing. Okay, if you want to. I mean, HB 49 is claimed, all right, what's been published in various blogs and whatnot. Let's just take HB 49. The claim is that Governor Scott has just signed into law that if you own a pipe, and you get caught with it the second time, you're going to be convicted of a felony. And that's not what HB 49 does.
All right. I didn't say it did, though.
Okay. Well, I know you didn't say it did, but that's what's being published out there. Everybody's slamming Scott for signing HB 49 as if it does something about ownership of drug paraphernalia or a pipe is the word that they're using. It actually is targeted at the retail sale of what is defined in previous state statute as drug paraphernalia, and it also that's that.
But as an abstract point here, though, because I didn't bring that up, but we can look at this as a lesson. We can't say Florida needs change. Florida needs radical leadership to get away from what has been adhered to with previous statutes, and then say, well, he's doing it because of previous statutes.
Yeah, but he doesn't have the authority to just go throw out previous statutes.
He doesn't, but he does have the authority to lead the people in the direction that they want to go. See, the people of Florida want to get away from exactly what you want to get away from, which is this crazy, insane idea that they have to adhere to the Florida Constitution, even if it's the violation of the U.S. Constitution, and they don't have to do that. That didn't happen. It didn't work for the people in Nuremberg. You wouldn't allow your kids to act like that. You wouldn't be able to say, well, Dad, my teacher told me, and he's the authority, to punch Billy, so I did. Well, you listen to the local authority. That's the way it was supposed to be. I mean, we wouldn't let our kids act like this, Ted.
All right, so what you're saying is that because Rick Scott is not picking up on some of the issues that you have, That means he's a
freedom is not an issue that I have. Freedom is an issue that all of us have. And I understand that his hands are tied in certain ways. I get that. But at least stand up there as the man that the Republicans wanted, the Tea Party wanted, and said, you know what? Even though I can't do it yet, I am fighting for your freedom. Work with me. Call your legislature. Let's get out of this DHS system. Let's get out of the privatization of prisons. Let's get out of this stupid thing that says if you've ever been convicted of any felony, you don't have the right to own a gun. That right there just shows a level of immaturity that suggests incompetence. And you know that, Ted. You are smarter than this. But that does it for today. Today, tomorrow, and as always, my friends, may your path lead to heaven and may freedom follow in your footsteps.